Hi there. In this video, we will discuss the highlights of the blog post, object tracking and re-identification with FairMOT. An object tracker tracks the movement of objects in a video, but in real-world scenarios, the movement information in itself has limited use cases. The detected object is tracked across the frames and is assigned a unique ID. Re-ID enables us in preserving the identity of the tracked object. There are several deep learning approaches that can track and re-ID together. Some of the popular models are SORT, DeepSort, JDE, Tractor, ByTrack, and FairMOT. FairMOT is a single-shot tracker that performs object detection and re-ID at the same time. It utilizes a joint optimization of the two tasks and enjoys high computation efficiency. This is the flowchart to track an object using FairMOT. First, the image is fed to the model. It has two homogeneous branches for the detection and the re-ID task. The detection branch is based on the anchorless architecture, SentinelNet. It has three heads, namely heat map, box size, and center offset. Heat map head gives the object centers. Box size head gives the target box dimensions. Due to downsampling, the object center might be misplaced by up to 4 pixels. Box offset or center offset helps localize the object precisely. The re-ID branch generates feature embeddings that help differentiate the objects. Next is the association stage. The model gives the bounding boxes and the re-ID feature embeddings for the current frame. Let's understand this with an example. The previous frame boxes and labels are given in green color, and the current frame's detection outputs are given in orange. It uses a two-stage matching strategy. In the first stage, we use Kalman filter, detected object, and the re-ID features for initial tracking results. We compute the cosine distances between the re-ID features of the current and the previous detections. Kalman filter estimates the new tracklet positions given in cyan, and we compute the Mahalanobis distance between the Kalman predictions and the current frame detections. Finally, we fuse the two distance values and use Hungarian algorithm to match the boxes from the previous frame to the next, up to a certain threshold. These are represented in pink. If any track fails, the second stage compares the amount of overlap or IOU of the boxes of the previous and the new frame. According to a threshold, the tracks are kept with the former ID. Otherwise, a new identity is assigned to the unmatched detections. Here are some of the results. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it informative. Like and subscribe for more such videos. Thank you.